So dear learners, what we are going to talk about today is something called convergence. Convergence is, if you look at that slide here, what an idea surgy. That what an idea surgy is an idea mobile ad, which actually encompasses this feeling or this concept of convergence very well. Let's go and have a look at it first. Convergence is a combination of it's a Latin word for two entities coming together. When two or more entities come together, it is called converger, which is where convergence has come in from. Nicolas Negroponte was one of the first persons who actually defined and represented convergence in a diagrammatic format. For example, he talked of broadcast and motion picture industry, print and publishing industry, and computer industry. When these three circles converge, when they intersect, he termed it as convergence. Let's go ahead. These are the common ground and starting point for defining the convergence. And the definition of convergence is essentially a description of digitalization. What we are doing today in today's world in the media field is basically digitalization. There are several studies that have taken place on convergence and several researches that have been done. For example, Swedish Agency for Innovation Systems called Vinnova presented a similar model in 2001, pointing out four areas of convergence: services, electronic appliances, networks, and market convergence. Convergence of services occurs when information traditionally connected with a certain media channel is provided through alternative media channels. For example, one television channel broadcasts other television channels' programs. If you look at the Sony sometimes, or even Zee, sometimes broadcasts Sony's programs. Or if there is a very, very popular program that is coming on another channel, it is broadcast by another channel. That is called convergence, and basically convergence of services. Electronic convergence is, of course, what we see today in the electronic world, in the media world, that electronic gadgets keep on coming together and together. For example, if you look at the mobile phone, that is probably the most convergent gadget today we use. Initially, when we started using a mobile phone, it was just for making calls and sending SMSs. But today, what we are using it for sending messages, we are using it for typing Word files, we are using it for creating PowerPoint presentations, we are using 3G to watch video, using it for even for shooting and uploading an MMS. These are the kind of convergent technologies that we are using today. The third area of convergence is the network convergence. Network convergence involves the integration of separate infrastructures and the distribution of services from other areas than the services traditionally distributed over a certain network. For example, internet. Now, internet encompasses a network. What is internet basically? If you look at it in a very very down-to-earth manner, internet is an international network of computers, clearly. But then what does it do? It encompasses LANs, WANs, and then wide area networks, and a city, a country, and ultimately becomes an internet. And this is what happens when you're talking of a network convergence. Market convergence, this is also a very important convergence, even though we are not dealing with market convergence directly as a media person. But as a media person, as a media student, you have to understand that even in the media market, there's a lot of convergence happening. So when it occurs when actors in the market move to adjacent areas which has not been previously been in the primary areas of India. For example, Reliance. Now look at Reliance. Reliance is primarily a telecommunication company. When it came into, I'm not talking of Reliance Industries in terms of petroleum. I'm talking of Reliance Industries in terms of communication. Came in as a telecommunication company. But what is Reliance doing now? Reliance is having Big Flix, that is the video rental channel. They're having a Big Cinema, which produces and big theaters where they distribute films. So they are into every form of communication and distribution of films. That is what is market convergence. So, What would ideally be a newsroom convergence? I get a story from one of the reporters, and I use the same story. I get a downlink from the satellite, I get a video feed from the satellite, capture it, use that feed to create a story for the television. I also quickly write a story or type a story for tomorrow's edition of newspaper. I write a script for the radio, and at the same time, I am capable of creating a web page and I use that capability to create a website, I mean, or add pages to my website. All this ideally should be the method by which newsroom conversions should happen, but we really don't have that right now in our country. Maybe in the future, very near future, I think it will happen. So some other studies of convergence, for example, Gordon has identified 5 types of convergence: ownership, tactical, structural, information gathering, and storytelling. In some of these theories, when we're going to look at this convergence, it will overlap, but we have to talk of the studies that have been done. Ownership convergence, of course, would be compared to merging of 2 companies. Tactical convergence is a form of cross promotion. So when I promote your program and you promote my program, that becomes a tactical convergence. Structural convergence is also very important. What is happening is today, I cannot claim to be a reporter, only a reporter who will carry, who will wear a jabba and a jhola and go out in the field and write a story by hand and give it to my audience. That is not enough. As a reporter, I should be able to do several other things. At the same time, as an editor, I should be able to edit the story, put together a page maybe, and due to this kind of skill sets, multiple skill sets that are necessary, what is happening is within the news industry, there is a lot of restructuring happening in terms of job structures. So if I join a newspaper organization as a reporter, I may not be just a reporter, but I might also have to go to the office, put together the page that I'm supposed to put. Suppose I'm covering sports beat, then it's not enough to just cover the sports and give it away to an editor. I might have to go there and put together the page in either Quark Express or PageMaker or InDesign and keep it ready for tomorrow's edition. That kind of structural convergence is happening in today's organizations. Information gathering, I don't know how it happens everywhere in the country, but in a city like Mumbai, this is a very prevalent form of convergence. What happens is, in a city like Mumbai, you can't be in all the places, and I cannot, as if I am the organization, I cannot keep reporters all over the city, because just to travel from one end of the city to the other end of the city, either east-west or north-south, it takes more than 1-2 hours. So if the news is happening in the south and I am in the north, I cannot cover it. What happens is, especially during the night time, what happens is these reporters, they after the shift is over by about 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock, they collect in a central place, chai pani peete hain. Aur us chai pani ke saath what they do is, they do camera to camera transfer. So if you have got a story and I don't have a story, you will give the camera, or you just plug in your wires and transfer the story to me. Which is why if you see in today's news broadcasts, sometimes if you switch channels with the remote, you'll see exactly the same picture in several news channels. There's no exclusivity in pictures. Everybody breaks the same news and with the same pictures. Maybe the narration is different. But why the same pictures? Because you have got information gathering convergence. That is what happens. Storytelling convergence is about new ways of to present information in different publishing channels. Now this is very common. I think media students will know how to convert a story for a different. If I am from a political party, or if I am, if my newspaper is affiliated to a political party, I'll have to frame my story according to that party's convenience. If I am from another opposition party or another party, then I'll have to frame my story according to that particular affiliation. So storytelling convergence always there. This is a very good model of convergence. What this actually talks about is, it's a convergence continuum. There is always a continuation. It's not you can't segregate one type of convergence from another type of convergence. So you've got cross promotion and cloning and co-opetition and content sharing and convergence. They are all together and they all interact with each other to form a complete convergence. You can't really segregate each type of convergence. There are some explanations about these convergences. Cross promotion is defined when partners cooperate. Cloning is when is the stage where material is republished into several channels. So maybe I have syndicated a column which is repeated by another channel. Or a simple example like Mahabharat serial, which started off with one channel and is being rebroadcast in several channels and still very popular. Co-opetition is something very important we should all know now, though it is in a very small point here in this particular presentation, but it's an important phenomenon. It is cooperation as well as competition at the same time. So what happens is at a higher level, I cooperate with you. So for example, if I want to place an ad in the newspapers about something, we together pool the resources and place a single ad for all of us. So if you and me are rivals in the field, but at an upper level, we put together some resources and place an ad in the newspaper. So we spend less. So if a newspaper ad is going to cost me, say, 50,000 rupees, it costs you 25, it costs me 25. In the field, we'll be rivals. We'll be rivals. We'll be competing with each other. So it's actually cooperative competition. And this is happening every day now in the field, and we should look at it as a student of media. Content sharing, I think we already talked about this. Content sharing, when we are talking of information gathering, the same as that. And full convergence, when we actually, you know, merge, according to authors at the level, cooperating partners share a central news desk. So in a way, somehow like Times of India sharing a desk with Mumbai Mirror, with Economic Times, and you know, so I have a single desk where I get stories from my reporters and share the stories with all the newspapers that I have in my group. Lawson Borders, another researcher, suggests another model where convergence is a concept as well as a process. Both. It's a concept as well as a process. So how does it work? Convergence as distribution of content through blending of traditional new media, which leads to doors opening to new opportunities in the media. For example, what you're seeing is today, a lot of folk media is used for communicating concepts. If you look at some of the channels, they are actually using puppets and cartoons. This is the kind of convergence we are talking about. Traditional one-way communication model is modified to include two-way communication. So if I've got a reality show going on, or if I've got a news story going on, for example, in Mumbai, there's a channel called IBN Lokmat. It's a Marathi channel. And they have a program every night called Aajcha Prashna, today's question. So there is a question. And what they do is they ask the viewers to send in their SMS every day. And based on that SMS, they keep on discussing. So today, if I'm discussing something and the SMSs say that the answer is either yes or no, it's not anything more. But based on that, the panel discussion keeps on changing. That is that two-way communication that is happening. This is the Lawson Borders model. Convergence source is the computer and the internet. And you've got medium, wireless print cable and radio television satellite. That is the way it is operating now. This is a picture which shows actually that everything is now converging towards a mobile phone, clearly. Rich Gordon has also defined convergence as content creation. I'm going to go quickly through this because it's kind of repeat of the previous ones. So content creation, you have to now be able to create content. So you have to learn Word, and from Word you should be able to take the data and the content to Quark Express or maybe something else, audio, video, everything that you have to do, or embed into the web page. Content distribution, we know that we already have access to the internet. It's a World Wide Web, and the distribution is happening so fast that today's news, I am recording today on the 2nd of May, and news that Osama bin Laden has been killed has already reached us, and he has died in Islamabad, somewhere in Islamabad. So that is what content distribution convergence is about. Content consumption is also very important because most consumers do not use digital display devices. They still use traditional media, but cable TV gives internet access but to computers. We can already see some key technology developments. Widespread use of content management systems are there. Wireless internet access, all these are actually taking place. One very important but a slightly neglected piece of technology is MTNL IPTV. IPTV actually comes through your broadband modem, which you have, router, which you get from your telephone company, from where you get your broadband internet connection. The same modem is used to give you television connectivity, and they actually give a very, very good quality television broadcast signal. Well, I already talked about this, but word convergence can be applied to these companies, their operations, the way employees do their jobs. Using this framework, we can identify at least 5 different types of convergence. Again, there's a repeat. Ownership. Only 3 groups, as I know of, have some kind of convergence: Times, Sakar, and Lokmat. We also have convergence in tactics. traditional media companies began engaging in a variety of activities that we can call tactical convergence, where daily tips and information, spot news, photography, enterprise reporting, events, public service. These are the kind of places where they have used convergence. Structure is changing, as we have already seen. Organization structures are bound to change with the new technology coming in. Information gathering, we already seen. When you talk of backpack journalism, like I told you, I mean, what we have is a backpack or a sack where you have got a camera and a laptop and a mobile phone and a data card and a tripod. That's it. You are a complete studio in itself. That is the kind of convergence we are talking about. What is happening because of that is that the quality of journalistic writing is deteriorating very fast, because that race for breaking news is actually killing the quality of journalistic writing. Presentation, of course, we have got storytelling convergence. When you talk of convergence, you also have to talk of divergence. We cannot ignore divergence when you're talking of convergence. Because what is divergence? Divergence is, today when I watch news on television, I'm not completely satisfied, because we know that television keeps on repeating the same news because they don't have enough content, video. Television is all about video content. So since I'm not satisfied, I immediately go to the website and look for news on Facebook or Twitter or whatever website. I am still not satisfied. I still wait for tomorrow morning's newspaper. So that I wait for tomorrow's morning. Then I switch on to my mobile phone and send some messages to my friends. Have you heard about this? Go to Twitter, see if Twitter has got anything. Go to YouTube and see if YouTube has got some videos. What we have actually in today's audience's hands is divergent medium. And which is where we are talking of, when you talk of convergence, we also have to talk of divergence. And just the way we media people have got technology, the audience also has got technology, and we should remember that. And we need to be able to create content for all possible distribution devices. Interactive and niche publishing encourages divergence, what we have been seeing, that because interactivity means you've got a technology. At the same time, the technology behind the services and production in the different channels are converging. So in production technology, there is convergence, whereas from the consumer's point of view, there is divergence, which is what we are talking about. One excellent example of divergence is blogging. Should we treat blog as an authentic journalism article? There are a lot of views about this, but ideally, a blog is written from the heart, whereas a journalistic writing is written from the brain. And frankly speaking, a journalist has to authenticate his story. Tomorrow, if I ask a journalist to prove what he has said, the journalist usually, ideally, has to have a proof of what, a documentation or something, which will show that what he's talking is truth. A blogger has no identity. If I decide that I should use your name tomorrow, I can use your name tomorrow and create a blog, and nobody will know who I am, unless there's a police case and there's a cyber cell investigating from the IP address. But ideally, blog writing need not be journalism, because there are some good journalists who are writing their blogs. Citizen journalism or participatory journalism, again, if it is authenticated, it is journalism, otherwise it is not. Well, so media convergence is an ongoing process, and if one process ends, another process immediately starts taking over that old process. So what are the implications? This is something which you have to think about. What are the implications of convergence? What are the benefits of convergence for people? What are the benefits for the media? These are the questions that you have to study and answer. Some very excellent examples of how information and communication technology has been used and how the convergent technologies have been used. Excellent example. There's one hole in the wall experiment. You might have heard of this. If you search the net, you'll definitely get it. Dr. Sugata Mitra from IIT Chennai, Madras, had an idea. There was a hole in the wall. If you can see this, there was a hole in the wall. What he did was he kept a computer screen and a keyboard and mouse and kept the PC inside. And there was a slum area outside the wall. And he just kept it open, free. Anybody could use it. And surprisingly, what happened is the children from the slum area learnt computers on their own. That is how convergent technology helps you. It actually worked that way. MS Swaminathan Research Foundation, they have got something called Village Knowledge Center and Village Research Center. This is a Chennai-based firm. What they do is they have got an excellent mobile experiment where they have distributed, they have created and distributed Tata Indicom phones, and they have actually created a software whereby one single click will give the information about the market rates, the weather, whether it's going to rain today or it's going to rain in that area or not. That is what convergence does to us. Nicholas Negroponte, who actually first defined, in one of the first slides we have seen, that he is the one who defined convergence in those intersecting circles. He has actually worked in India. He has come to India in a village called Khairat, which is near Karzat. And see, this is the kind of village, 20 houses and 200 people. What he did was he distributed these computers. They can be charged by hand, actually. They don't have a battery. And one computer, one laptop per child. And he teaches a computer to these children in a very, very small remote village. And they learn very fast. So what problems do we have with convergence? Social responsibility theory. We know there is something called social responsibility theory, which is supposed to, that the media is supposed to be socially responsible. What we see today in the media, I think you should look at it and talk about it. Framing theory. You know that you can frame a story as you want. So I can, with one incident, I can change the outlook of the whole story completely to suit my own purpose or my organization's purpose. Gatekeeping. Do I have any kind of gatekeeping now? Because if you're talking of gatekeeping when you've got so many people sharing the same video, what is there to gatekeep? Backpack journalism, I've already talked about backpack journalism, breaking news. This phenomenon is actually breaking the back of journalism. And of course, attention to details. The tendency today is to simply Google. And whatever results you get, you use for your news story, which is a dangerous phenomenon, which is, has come up because of convergence. So the questions that you need to answer now is there really content convergence in the media? Who benefits from it? The media organizations or the people? If you took a look at some of the examples, if Chandrababu Naidu's one window phenomenon, because he's the one who, digitalized all the land records in Andhra Pradesh, and thus you could get records from one single window. IRCTC.co.in, the railway site, is one of the best sites India has, B2C sites India has, a completely convergent website. We also have some other problems like convergence and isolation. I have an iPod which I carry along with me, and once I put those earplugs in my ear and start listening to the songs, I am cut off from the whole world. I am isolated from the world and the world is isolated from me. That is one problem we have to talk about. Marginalization, so we have got something called digital divide. Convergence, the more convergent technology is coming up, the more people who don't have access to that technology are being, sidelined. That kind of marginalization is happening. So internet is a myth or a reality. I think now it is a reality, but we still have to look at the convergent part of it. And the communities, of course. Mobile phones we are using now with 3G networks coming in, I think it's going to be the medium of choice for even the media companies, because what you have now is face-to-face conversations, you have video downloading, and possibly news broadcast. Instead of television channels, I can watch news while traveling. And on-the-spot news, immediate news, real-time news, which is what convergence is going to do to mobile phones. And I think that the next 5 years are going to be very interesting in terms of the delivery of content over media. Which media are we going to really use? Well, that's what this ad, I like the ad when I saw the ad, because it actually talks of convergence when the hero actually uses a mobile phone to teach several children sitting beside, that is the ideally, that should be the convergent medium that we have to use for education more than entertainment. Thank you.